Good morning, children. Today we are going to start chapter 3, Kingdom Classification. So let's start with the introduction to animal kingdom. Children, you know that all animals, they are eukaryotic, multicellular and heterotrophic in nature. Means they have well-defined nucleus, the body is made up of multiple cells and their mode of nutrition is heterotrophic in nature. That means they do not manufacture their own food. An animal's cell, they do not have cell wall. Mostly animals are mobile in nature, that means they move from one place to another place, so, except some of the species. The children, on the basis of the differences, we can classify the animals into invertebrates and vertebrates. So invertebrates are those which do not have backbone or the notochord, and vertebrates are those which have the backbone or the notochord. So human beings come under vertebrates. So let's start with the classification of invertebrates or the non-chordates. So when these invertebrates, you do not have backbone, their body may have delicate skeleton or they do not have a skeleton at all, and they are divided into different phylum. So let's start with the phylum Porifera, or the pore-bearing organism. Now these organisms, they are usually found in marine, and they are sessile in nature and they are remain attached to the substratum part. They are non-motile animals and they are commonly called the sponges. The body is asymmetrical or radially symmetrical, and the sponges, they look like vase, and they are round, they are sack-like, or they may be brass. Now, as you see that they are pore-bearing animals, that means their body is perforated with numerous pores, and they have also one large size outlet for the water, and it is known as ostula. Now, the canal system, it is filter-feeding system of sponges. Now, it helps in circulating the water through the body to bring food, oxygen and water. So means that osculum is there for the exchange of the food, the oxygen and water. Mouth, digestive cavity, anus, all are absent. And the animals which include in phylum Porifera, they are the cycan, leucosolenia, eupelectella and spongula. Now come to phylum Nidaria or the Cnidaria. Now these animals, they are also living in water. Mostly they live in marine, and they are few animals which live in fresh water like hydra. Now in this, a central gastrovascular cavity is present, which is known as cilentrin, and it lacks the anus, but it has mouth which is surrounded by slender tentacles. Respiratory, circulatory and excretory organs all are absent in these cilentrates. Nervous system is present, but it is very primitive in nature and it has only network of nerve cells. Their mouth, it is surrounded by finger-like projections called the tentacles. Now these projections, they are possessed for stinging the cells, which help in ensuring defense and arresting the prey. Most common example of cnidarians or the cnidarians are hydra, jellyfish, sea anemone. Now let's come to the phylum Platyhelminthes. Now our children, Platyhelminthes are also known as flatworms. Now their body is thin, soft, leaf-like or ribbon-like, and they are diploblastic animals. That means they have three embryonic germ layers. That means ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. Now their digestive tract has opening mouth, but anus it is absent. The suckers and hooks are present to make this organism to fit in the particular organ or the particular animal. Now circulatory and the respiratory system both are absent in them, and they are hermaphrodite in nature. That means both the male and the female organs, they are present in the same individual. Now, the examples are the planaria and liver fluke. Now, come to phylum nematodes. Now, these nematodes, they are worm-like organisms or the animals, and their body is round, slender, and tapering at the ends. That means they are pointed at the ends. The body, it is covered with the cuticle and cilia are absent. Now, their body is also, elementary canal is also completed with the mouth and the anus. And the pharynx is muscular in nature. The sexes, they are separate. That means male and female, they are on the separate organism. Now, most forms, they are parasitic in nature, but sometimes they are free living in soil or water. For example, Ascaris, Lumbricoides, Boucheria bronchopti, Anthrobius. Okay? Now, come to phylum Annelida, and they are also known as segmented worms. Now, their body, it is metrometrically segmented, and they have transverse grooves, and internally they are divided by the septa. Now, some of the anterior body segments, they concentrate and they form a head. Now, the exoskeleton is absent, body is covered by a thin cuticle, and they have locomotory organs known as appendages. Their elementary canal is also completed, that means they have the mouth and anus, and they are the true having the animals with the true body cavity and with closed blood vascular system. Now, cilium, it allows the true organs to be packed in the body structure. Now, excretion by the paired segmented nephridia, which removes the waste from the cilium and blood stream directly to the exterior. Now, the nervous system, it consists of the dorsal brain and the ventral nerve cord, having the ganglia and the lateral nerves in each body segment. Now, reproduction by sexual means, and they are also hermaphrodite in nature, or they may be separate or unisexual. Now, they live in variety of the habitats, children. Mostly they are aquatic, they are marine, or sometimes they are freshwater animals. Some are terrestrial also, which lives in the moist soil or burrowing in the tubers. Some also free living forms. Now, the examples which comes under annelids are the earthworms. Now, these earthworms, they live in soil and it gets their nutrition from it. And leech, it is a parasite that which sucks blood to the host. Okay? Now, this is all for today, children. In next class, we'll continue with the other phylum. Okay? So, thank you and have a nice day.